like, you know, obviously there's an narrativity to cinema because it's in time, just the way it's an narrativity to music. Mm-hmm. But, you know, you don't first think of the story of the song and then make the song. You know, it has to come out of that moment, mm-hmm. you know, and that's what film has. It's just that moment, which is holy, you know, and like this moment, you know, it's holy. But like we walk around like it's not holy. We walk around like, you know, there are some holy moments and there are all the other moments that are not holy, right?
Right.
But like this moment's holy, right? And I feel like film can let us see that, you know, it can like, frame it so that we see like, ah, this moment, you know, holy. And it's like holy, 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 moment by moment. But like who can live that way, you know? Who can like go, wow, holy? Because if I were to like look at you and just really like let you be holy, I don't know, I would like stop talking.
Well, you'd be in the moment. I mean,
well, like, let's do it right now. Like, let's have a holy moment.
Okay.
What sets cinema apart from other art forms? What makes it unique? Cinema captures moments with all the imperfections of real life. The spontaneous reactions like and unplanned interruptions that are so familiar to real existence.
Ever-changing face of God. You have a mosquito. Do you want me to get it for you? You got it.
Got it.
Yeah, you got it.
Okay.
And like, this is what sets Richard Linklater's cinema apart. What makes it so that you can't imagine seeing these films as books or pieces of theater? The essence of what makes them great is the very fact that they exist, with every imperfection, as cinematic works, at the intersection of dream, memory, and reality. These moments can seem mundane at first, but if you watch it again, you notice the relief at a brief moment of kindness.
You need a ride?
Or a moment of surreality. The films allow for sublime moments, because they don't force them. They let them happen and pass unremarked. But these moments are invariably about people and their relationships with each other, whether between lovers, kids and parents, our natural enemies. So what do Linklater's films teach us about creating connections with audiences? A direct-to-camera monologue may attempt to cut out all the bullshit, but it weakens the relationship between the audience and the filmmaker. We, the audience, should be communicating with the filmmakers by watching others interact within the frame. They are framed by the filmmakers for us, so we can see the situation and understand something about them. The holy moment happens on the self-contained plane of reality of which we are witnesses, not participants. The way we barely recognize these moments in our own lives when they happen to us.
You know, I believe if there's any kind of God, it wouldn't be in any of us. Not you or me. But just this little space in between. If there's any kind of magic in this world, it must be in the attempt of understanding someone, sharing something. I know, it's almost impossible to succeed, but who cares, really? The answer must be in the attempt.
The holy moment is a glimpse of self-awareness. It always passes.